I tell you who was a player who stood out this season. Heung-min Son. Oh. I know I'm getting ahead of myself
here. Getting ahead of yourself there, Shaka.
But listen, how he isn't even on the shortlist doesn't make the PFA team is simply beyond me. But from that shortlist, and again, to everybody's point, I don't think there's a lot between the main contenders.
Just seeing as though you gave us a tease, we will bring you the PFA Team of the Year, which, as Shaka mentioned, Heung-min Son has not made, despite the fact that he was shared Premier League Golden Boot winner without a single penalty among his goals as well. Alisson, Trent Alexander-Arnold, Virgil van Dijk, Rudiger, Cancelo, Silva, Thiago, Kevin De Bruyne, Salah, Ronaldo and Mane all in there. But the glaring omission, Heung-min Son. Shaka's upset about it. What do you think about it, Mark?
Yeah, I mean, he was a joint top scorer in the Premier League, wasn't he? He's the guy that was tied with Salah. So, you know, he's definitely deserving of the award. So I think he should be in the team. But Ronaldo scored a lot of goals. Salah scored a lot of goals. Mane scored a lot of goals. So, yeah. Who do you leave out in that
Ronaldo country? Scored a lot of goals for a team that finished, what, sixth? Heung-min Son scored a lot of goals for a team that kind of eclipsed expectation and finished in the top four.
So what's harder to do, though, is that not, can that play a factor into it, that you can still shine when the team aren't doing so well, or should Son be in there instead of Ronaldo?
Well, I think what we have to be very careful about here is that we're not giving a lifetime achievement award, which is what seems to be for Cristiano Ronaldo. Now, did he have a productive season, much more productive than we thought it was going to be with Manchester United? Yes. But to Shaka's point, look, how many times in this show we have spoken about Manchester United, and every time, mostly, it's in a negative manner. There hasn't been anything uplifting about Manchester United. I suppose the one sort of sign of positive energy would be Cristiano Ronaldo. That's still not enough to make it into the team of the year. It's a great story for Ronaldo that he stands out in Manchester United, but I don't think it's enough for him to be above the guy that, hey, if you lead the league in scoring, you have to be somewhere in that front three. Somewhere. And if you don't think it's Salah, and if you don't think it's Mane, then the guy that has to be out of that list is Cristiano Ronaldo. And I know Ronaldo fans are going to go crazy. Oh, how dare you do this to Cristiano. I don't think that Cristiano is all that concerned about it. But to be honest with you, it just feels like Heung-min Son has to be on this team. And Cristiano Ronaldo is more of a lifetime achievement than actually being more deserving than Heung-min Son.
The argument for Ronaldo can only revolve around the fact that Manchester United was so disappointing. That Manchester United season, the only real successes you could point to, if you want to call it that, David De Gea and Cristiano Ronaldo. Whereas with Spurs, there's a lot more you can point to aside from Heung-min Son, Harry Kane, Kulusevski coming in January, the impact that Antonio, you could make all sorts of arguments as to why maybe it doesn't live up to the importance of Ronaldo, or Heung-min Son's importance to Spurs doesn't match Ronaldo's importance to Manchester United. But every single striker in this game will tell you strikers are judged on one thing and one thing only, goals. So if that is the measure of a striker, and Heung-min Son, who is not Spurs' main striker, leads the league in scoring, I'm not quite sure how you start to fashion that argument for Ronaldo. I understand how you start to fashion it, but I don't understand how that ultimately is your conclusion.
Well, and I think it can't be that the argument for you is, hey, my team was so bad, I scored 18 goals, and so now I should be team of the year. Well, I'm just going to put something out there. He is part of the team. It's not just him and 10 other guys. So he may be the outstanding player in a bad team, but this is still a situation in which you have a group of players that underachieve. And Cristiano Ronaldo is part of that group of players. Mm. And I don't think you can separate both of them, and certainly you cannot put Ronaldo at a level in which, hey, he's on the team of the year, the rest of his teammates are awful, but we're just going to love Ronaldo, and then we're not going to talk about the rest of Manchester United. It just doesn't make any sense.
Mark, you were talking on the show about Manchester United prioritising getting Cristiano Ronaldo out the door. Should he be out of this list in this PFA Team of the Year?
I'd take Mane out of the list. I think that Ronaldo deserves where he is because of the goals he scored, but I'd take Mane out because I think Liverpool could have done what they did without Mane's goals to Salah's goals. I know it's kind of complicated, but I'd be interested to see what Xhaka thinks, because when players vote, do they take it seriously, or do they just put the names that come to mind?
You're asking the absolute wrong person here. I stopped voting. So I stopped voting, in all seriousness, in 99. David Ginola won Player of the Year in 99. Manchester United did the treble. For me, of course, my opinion was rather biased, especially at the time. I thought Dwight York should have won it. So once somehow, I don't know how you picked David Ginola. I can't remember exactly where Spurs finished that season. But once some kind of criteria is established where Ginola was better than everybody from Manchester United, then I divorced myself from that process back then. And so I played on for another, what, 8 years? I never voted after that.
So some may not take it too seriously, because, yeah, it is worth reminding, this is the award that is voted by the players. Xhaka not happy with his fellow players.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.